Okay, so welcome to the next part here where we get working on the cabinet. And it's in really good shape, as you saw in the first part in the showcase, if you will. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this black touch-up paint for automotive touch-ups and stuff to do all of the scratches and scrapes, you know, like right there. And it should turn out just fine. That's what I really have used in the past. I don't know if I want to actually mask off the sides and front and spray paint it. I have done that in the past, but it really doesn't need it. It's in good shape, but I think a good cleanup will work. But just touching up areas like that with the touch-up paint should work pretty well as well. So, yeah, it's not overall that bad. You know, you can use the black to touch up all the areas down there and right there. Yeah, otherwise it's really not too bad. So, yeah, we'll get working on it. I'll get it all cleaned up and touched up, and the inside is nice and clean. I need to mount the power supply. It's kind of floating around in there, but it's all vacuumed out. The wiring harness is in shambles because I robbed the harness to do some testing inside. But it doesn't matter because it's all going to end up getting rerouted and everything, so not a big deal. But you can see the inside's in good shape. Nothing really missing, all cleaned up. So, yeah, I guess I'll just get the camera on the tripod. And you can watch me wipe it down, touch it up, clean it up, and then we'll kind of get going on the install and the board installation and everything. You know, these metal brackets are kind of corroded and pitted and seen much better days. Just the bottom ones, though. The top ones are really good. The bottom ones are all messed up, so I don't know what caused all of that, but I'll get them all cleaned up. I'll get the black, the retaining bars for the control panel all sanded down. Oh, as a matter of fact, let me show it to you. Yeah, it's pretty rusty. Yeah, so this is gonna get sanded down and repainted. So that'll be part of this as well. So I'll get the camera set up and you can watch me and we'll see how it turns out. This is everything that was inside the machine, which is all the original stuff, kind of. It's pretty neat. We've got, see if I can set that there, we've got this folder here full of connectors and stuff. I don't know what they're for. I don't know what this stuff is, but it's part came with the machine. It's an adapter of some kind, and another jumper plug of some kind, and a fuse and extra coin door light. So that's what came in this folder here. Let's see if I can put all this back together. Probably not. No, I'll just set it aside for now. And it came with this troubleshooting paper, board repair form. October 15, 1998. This has been sitting in here for 23 years, this paper. Wow. It says MK4, I don't know what word that is, doesn't do anything. Okay. Let's see, check power and connectors, something, JAMA before sending it to customer, who knows. But interesting, that must have been a warranty claim because it was only probably a year old at that point. The manual for the monitor, so that monitor that was in here was the original monitor from 23, 24 years ago. So we've got that, pretty neat. The ROM upgrade kit to go from, I guess it was probably 1.0 to 2.0, I think. Still pretty interesting. Kind of cool to have this. And of course the manual and some installation instructions for the coin door, which is kind of odd. Field installation instructions is an actual document. Awesome. Pretty interesting on that. And then the folder that they were all in. So, yeah, pretty neat. And you can see the dust and dirt here where the panel was versus where there was nothing. So pretty dirty. But let's get the camera set up and I'll get to cleaning up and we'll see how it all turns out. So watch this. Thank you. Okay, just one side wiped down and you can see just how dirty it was. This is just one side compared to, you know, a new side. This is this is just from one side. So let's keep going and see how the rest of it turns out. Well, this side, I believe, and I feel, is complete. We've got the touch-up done for all the scratches and the sides here. There was a scratch right there. We got that touched up. There was a mark right there we got touched up. There was this scratch right here I got touched up. It's not any award-winning work, but it's a lot better than it was. We got some other parts, I believe, down here in the corner. I forget. Anyway, yep, so I think this side is good to go as far as it needs to be. So let's flip the cabinet around and do the other side. All right, so let's get that done. Now this side's done now, and it was much dirtier than the other side. This was a brand new rag when I started. You can see here's the other side, and then here's the dirty side. So yeah, this was a lot dirtier than the other side. So let's get the touch-up done, and we'll see how that goes. Side two is now complete. It's not perfect because I don't have any orange or yellow to touch up here, but that's okay. But we got the major areas all done. Again, not award-winning work, but better than it was. And nothing to write home about, but it's you know, good. So this area there, the areas around the bottom, you can see where it was done. Yeah, you were watching. Got the edges. So yeah, everything else is pretty good. So let's stand it back up and we'll get the rest of the inside and outside wiped down. I think all that's left is the front, which again is in good shape, just a little minor few scratches and scrapes. And then we'll see how it goes. So let's see. So the front is done now, as much as I want to do to it. I left the lock bar thing in there. I don't really care about that. Not a big deal. But you can see I added the yellow T-molding. Very quick and easy on both sides. And it looks pretty good so far. We'll see how it turns out for the rest of the install. But yeah, we're all done with touch-up on the front. And that pretty much completes the outside of the cabinet. I guess instead of... I should say it completes it except for the T-molding here, which I may do next. And then we'll get to the inside. I'll wipe down, cleaned up, try and get these cleaned up. And then for the next part, we'll see... Well, actually, you know what? I forgot. I got to do the stripping and painting of the glass retainer and the top of the control panel bracket. I also got to take this apart, take this off, and do the painting of the grill and clean up of the glass of the marquee, get this back and reinstalled, clean the top of the cabinet, and then we'll pretty much be done. So here we go. Well, as you saw there, with the complete removal of all of the rusted areas and the surface rust, full sanding down, and I reshot it with some black gloss paint. It's still drying. There's a couple of runs, but nothing that can't be touched up later, or actually it's kind of okay in my opinion. So let's get this all back together and continue on with the cabinet. I got to get the marquee glass cleaned and the marquee cleaned up, and then I'll get the speaker grill back installed, and this stuff can go back on later because this will be done at another point. So we'll get the speaker grill back on, we'll get the marquee glass cleaned up and the marquee cleaned up, get that all back together, and then we'll proceed on from there. So stand by. Thank you. Okay, these monitor brackets are just too far gone to try and wipe down. Look at that corrosion on there. That's just insane. So it's just going to have to be sanded down to really keep this from getting worse. So here we go. So they're not perfect, but they're much better than they were. So I am happy with the way they turned out. They're good enough for what they need to be. They're not gonna rust and fall off. Not that they were before, but at least they're better than they were. So that's been done. These are actually okay. I got the glass cleaned on both front and back, got the marquee reinstalled, the retainer as you saw, and the freshly painted grill with all new security screws. And I probably could have touched this up or sanded it down a bit, but it's okay. It's a carriage bolt for ground. So let's get ready and do the rest of the inside of the cabinet. Give it a good wipe down. Got to do the top still too. And then we'll put the control panel on here and deal with that and see how it turns out. We got to do the T-molding. And I have a separate, I'm going to do the T-molding here. But I'm going to make a separate post about just the T-molding on this particular part as an installation guide on how to change the T-molding out, because you can see here that it's coming out. You can see it's coming out, and you can see in here that there's no slit in the T-molding, and that's why it comes out. So I'm going to make a separate installation video. It's still going to be included on this series in this video of installing the T-molding, but I'm going to cut that part out and make a separate video posted just by itself on how to install T-molding, because a lot of people get this wrong. Even the factory didn't do it right, and that's why it's coming out here. It doesn't stay in, and I'll show you the secret to that. So I'll get this wiped down inside and out top, and that'll seal up everything on the cabinet but the T-molding and the control panel, and we'll get that shortly afterwards. So here we go. Let's take a minute here and talk about T-molding and the correct installation of it. You can see on the opposite side I already have the new T-molding installed. This side I don't. And I want to show everybody out there how to do this properly. So first thing you're going to need is a sharp knife so you can cut, and a nice rubber mallet. And I'll explain why you want to use the rubber mallet here in a minute. Well, I guess if you use a hammer, it puts indentations in the T-molding. You don't want that. The rubber mallet does not do that. Also, you can use the handle when you go around the curves to press it in without damaging the surface of the molding. So, let's talk about how it's installed in properly from the factory. You can see here, if you zoom in, it's not sitting in the channel all the way. And that's because any point where it goes around, it makes a curve, you need to cut a V in the material, in the part of the T-molding that sits in the channel, the T itself. You got to cut some material out of there, so when you make that curve, it sits in the groove. So let me take this out, and I'll show you what I mean. Okay. So everywhere that it curves, You can see along the top up here where the first curve is, there is no relief cut into it. They just take it and they smash it over. Well, when it smashes over, it bunches up like that and then doesn't sit in the groove properly. So when you get around to where it goes in around here, this point, you can see that they did not have a groove cut in there either. So over time, the tension of the T-molding will push itself out. So what you want to do in that instance, you want to take your knife and you want to cut a V. You want to cut a V in the material like this, and then get rid of this. Goodbye. So when it bends around, now you can see that when it bends, it has a relief, a 90 degree angle there, and it will go around the corners and sit in the groove perfectly. So that's how you want to do that. So let's do that on this side. I'm going to start up here at the top. I'm going to use our mallet to hammer it in. Okay, so now we're up here at the corner. So what you want to do is cut that groove in there. So, just like that. So now when it goes around the corner, it'll stay in there forever. So you always, I want to get a bit of tension on here and pull it a little bit. The slot is holding the molding in there. That's unfortunate. But give it a good pull, and as you're pulling on it, perfect. Just like that. So let's zoom out here. Or actually, let's just angle down. And we'll go to, we'll show both of these wraps in frame here. Get the right position on here, and we'll start, we'll go here and there, and take that out. Now here's where the mallet comes in, because you can use your mallet to kind of, like if you're rolling dough, you can use the mallet handle to kind of get it in there without using this end, and you'll dent the tip of this, will put dents in the molding. So you want to kind of roll it in there with your handle. Bit on the molding to keep this in the groove, and then work your way down as you're pushing up on the molding. Work your way down with your thumb here, and once it sits in there nice, then you can continue on with the rest of it. So you can see that sits in there much better now. And if we go down here to this corner, it's more of the same story. You want to make sure you get the bend and the cut right. This one's a bit trickier, because you want to kind of size up where it needs to end up. I'd say probably roughly here. Then we'll cut our piece out for the turn. And we'll have to hammer that in. Well, that's about as good as that is going to be. So there you go. That is about how you want to do that. So hopefully it helps you out. I see a lot of people install this stuff incorrectly, so that's kind of the best way to do it, is cut those grooves out of there, and when it bends around the corners, it'll go in nice and easy. So, and what I was saying earlier, I think it was off frame, is
hold this in with your thumb or your mallet or whatever, and you want to grab this as you're installing it and push up on it. So when you push up on it, it'll keep it seated in here. As you're pushing up, while it's still seated, you can hammer it in or push it in. And once it stays in, then you can get the hammer and hammer it into the mallet. So I think that was off frame when I was just describing that. So yep, there it is. So hopefully it helps you out. And if you're interested in this series, if you're not actually watching this part of the series and you're watching just this installation video, go check out the series of this project. I think you'll like it. So hopefully it helps you out, and we'll see you next time. If you're here watching the series, just keep on watching. Well, the cabinet now is basically done. I got all the T-molding installed, as you saw, and it looks kind of neat, if you ask me, in my opinion. So we'll see how it looks once the project is complete. I got this all cleaned up. You saw how it was before. We got the monitor brackets cleaned up. You saw I got the inside of the cabinet wiped out and cleaned up, and I got all the harness removed. The harness is over here. You can actually, it's modular, so you can take all that stuff out. But yep, it's all clean now, ready to go. So I have to do the control panel. We'll get that put back on here. We'll get it touched up and get the nails out, I'll figure out what to do with that point. We'll get the control panel on here and get that fixed up. I figure that will end the cabinet restoration part of this project. And then very shortly after this, once I get this video edited and uploaded, I'll begin working on the electronic part of it with the boards and the switcher installation. And then that will complete the project. So stay tuned for that. Let's get the control panel on here and get it figured out. Well, here we are. Cabinet work is complete. And we'll get to the control panel here in a moment. But it's not a masterpiece, but it is certainly much better than it was. I kind of like the yellow T-molding. We'll see if I keep it and what the general consensus is, but I kind of like it. The side here, I took out both of these nails and put a screw back in. I'll just show you here. I put this piece back in that was missing, and I'm using the screw to hold it in there while the glue is drying. Once the glue dries, I'll take this screw back out, and you'll still see the hole, but it's not too bad. You know, I can't really touch this up with black, or it'll offset this too much. I just touched up what I could with some black. You know, it's not, like I say, it's not perfect, but I don't want to have to go through and do, I'm not interested in doing full-blown artwork on the control panel. It's not worth it because it might end up going right back in the arcade, but because you still got issues like this. I mean, it's not perfect, but anyway, so yeah, that's how this side turned out. Everything else I think is in great shape. The control panel itself is really above and beyond how I expected it to turn out when I began this. You can see I did some touch up there and kind of put a black line across the bottom edge of it. But everything else turned out pretty well. This here I can't do much about. I could probably touch it up, but I don't want it to offset too much, so I'm not really too worried about it. But yeah, the front and the control panel turned out great. This turned out spectacular. All of this work here, getting rid of all the rust and repainting this turned out factory fresh. Really proud of how that turned out. I got the glass cleaned front and back, got the bezel cleaned. I spray painted and cleaned up and replaced the screws on the speaker grill. We cleaned the glass and the marquee. We cleaned the top of the cabinet, the inside, the front, everything. It's all cleaned up. You saw the whole process there. So, yeah, it turned out real nice. This side isn't too bad, except for right here. I guess it's kind of hard to see with the glare. I'm sorry, the garage door is open, but this side turned out just as well as the other side. I gotta be careful how I angle this because the light from the outside will make it go away, but yeah. Glorious. So we're all done with the cabinet work. Off camera, yeah, I went ahead and installed the control panel. I'm missing a bolt, but it's not too bad because that bolt's installed and these two are installed and it's nice and secure. Not a concern for me at this point. Let's go ahead and put this back in here while we have it open. If I can. Probably can't. There we go. Yep. and we'll find out if the wiring is good on the joysticks later. So we are ready for the electronics portion of this. Everything turned out flawless. So yeah, stay tuned for that and we'll see how it goes. Everything's in here and ready. This was attached to the control panel, so I just have this setting in here, but yeah, I'll have to probably move the power junction there. I may not have to, we'll see. I'll have to get rid of that fan and I'll have to get rid of these clamps, and we'll strategically move some stuff around and see how it all turns out. So I'll get this uploaded and I'll get to work on this part immediately afterward once I get done editing this and get it out there for you guys to check out. I will immediately begin on the internals.